Hallo. Ich möchte euch herzlich begrüßen zu Münchenseite.
Welcome to Methodically Wrong. I'm so happy to be able to announce this show's this show. Well, no, it's not like I didn't do it last time as well.
Hakech Mojikov. Kostak noch? Klam Luch B, Jelich Renov.
Was willst du hier?
What are you doing here?
Nächstes Jahr vielleicht, dieses Jahr ist es falsch.
No, maybe you can announce the show next year, but it's the wrong franchise for this year.
Tut mir leid.
I'm so sorry.
Jetzt lege ich mich auch noch auf die Fresse wahrscheinlich. Nee, ernsthaft, Minkorrekt. Also die beiden
Methodically Wrong. The two of them make an awesome podcast every other week. Give a big round of applause to them for that.
Noch nicht das ganze Pulver verschießen, ihr braucht noch ein bisschen gleich.
Yeah.
Ja, wenn's richtig anfängt.
Spare your excitement for later on and collect some power for later on. Here's the M-Team of Science. I forgot my text. I forgot my lines.
Also, ich hab ja einen.
Das M-Team der
The M-Team of Science, Podcast. The podcast.
Dr.
Wörl and Reinhold. No, Reinhard.
Remford. Incorrect.
Methodically wrong.
Und sag mir jetzt nicht, dass deine Technik versagt.
Don't tell me that your technology is failing.
Einmal mit Profis.
Wouldn't it be nice to work with professionals for once?
Ja, so ist das.
Oh, that's how it goes.
Jetzt sieht das so aus, als sei das irgendwie die falsche Frequenz, die hier gesendet wird.
It looks like this might be sending on the wrong frequency.
Genau. Licht aus, bitte. Jetzt fangen wir an. Viel lauter.
Long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away.
Louder.
Episode 33, Revenge of the Minkrake Knights. Dr. Nicholas is on his home planet, CCH, and together with his old friend, Reinhold Renford Rheinland, with his friends, they want to excite the people with their experiments. They don't have a clue that the rebels hidden as the fire guard in Tsar 1 did not allow them to have their mincrack there. So we have to be in Hall Chi, codename Besenkammer.
Broom cupboard.
So the end is near, and all the work for science is required to make them look cool again.
Methodically Wrong has entered the CCH. They really get tickets.
Yes.
Das war ja klar, da schicken sie wieder mich.
It was obvious they were going to send me. Oh, it's not going to be that bad. Oh God.
Remford, wir sind erfreut, dass Sie doch noch ein Ticket für den Kongress bekommen.
Lord Remford, we're happy to have a ticket.
Save your empty words, I'm here to inspect Rose, Hall 1.
So Remford, last time, they're all little smelt.
Hall 1 is big enough so that nobody will notice.
The sausages were still there in summer.
It was the best Sauerländer Knackwurst.
CDH wasn't happy and they were afraid of also the floor of filled with beer.
The Congress Center is being renovated entirely.
But there's also hot tea.
Are you going to put us in that horrible broom cupboard again? I hope not. The Doc is not as patient and benevolent as I am.
Get up, young Padawan. Is everything ready in Hall 1?
They won't let us into Hall 1. They're speaking of health and safety, that's against it.
Always the security and safety issues. Having proof that we can do this? What do they hackers think who they are? And where is for news show?
In Hall 1, my lord.
That's enough. I don't want to be treated like an Elsevier. This year we are very nice, nothing dirty, and the last day we're taking over the closing ceremony. And then we'll be in Hall 1, finally.
Starting next year.
Then we'll take over the whole Congress and do it all alone.
Did you notice I had the blue one?
Damn!
Oh, how wonderful.
Exactly the same in year, and I completely forgot what I was going to say. Reinhard is enjoying. Hello. We also want to do something like unprofessional. We expected something unprofessional from the organization, so we don't like that bad. They're really doing a good job there. Okay, Reiner, he's enjoying it.
Yeah.
That's the moment where the expectations are still high. Everything is here.
I wanted to say, welcome to today's disappointment. Always these expectations.
Yeah, we got a lot of us. 2 years ago, we were just thinking about it today. We have been in the Sendezentrum. We've been there, how shall there? We brought a suitcase.
Under the escalator, out of a suitcase.
It was a little bit like, so I want to talk about science with you. Okay, last year, we were surprised the most, I suppose, and also the real. Okay, this expression, we can't hold it today. We're going to try it anyway. We brought something today.
Das, was wir so durften.
So, what we were allowed to.
Correct.
Das ist übrigens der Grund, warum wir nicht in Saal 1 sind.
That's the reason why we're not in Hall 1. Because people are asking in. In Hall 1 there's no fire allowed. Not even a candle. Okay, that's something we can't do. Nothing without fire. And that's why we're here in this room. That's nice you're being here with us.
We could put up a sign all the time, you know, well, each time we do something that wouldn't have been allowed in Hall 1.
Again, in this. So also, hi to the other other rooms. So Hall 1 and Sendezentrum, hi. Thanks for watching. What you've just seen was a Tesla Travo. You can do other funny things. For example, you can do.
Yeah, I didn't want you to hurt yourself. Yeah, we're a bit close.
Tesla Transformator gives like 20,000 watts up here. That's not that many currents. So I can get lightnings.
So the power is not that huge.
Of course.
Can I try that as well? Can I use your car key for it? The only reason why you use a key and not your finger is because you would burn your finger quite enormously, because the place where that little branch of plasma hits your finger or hits whatever it is gets pretty warm.
Yes, the thing was invented by Nikola Tesla. Tesla was an interesting person. He wanted to, also at the beginning of his career as a scientist, he had some very good ideas. That reminds you of someone. Ah, no, just kidding, not you.
You never had good ideas, did you?
You can't take away my jokes.
I'm sorry.
Two-phase
alternating current.
So in the North America, it was direct discussed how we do this with the currents, directed and alternating current. So one of the candidates talking about us.
He also invented the electric engine, and I don't know how many hundreds of patents. Last time I was in Darmstadt for a small talk, a man came up to me and asked me how I felt about Tesla, because he rejected Einstein, as everybody knows. So everything you want to know about Tesla, just read up on it on your conspiracy theorist's board of choice. But what I was going to say, Tesla got a bit too much of his own alternating fields, and eventually he was still a genius, but in a state where he was being visited by aliens and he was on Pluto.
Yeah, probably at one of these experiments. That's an early Photoshop.
Double exposure.
During they took this picture, he wasn't in the room, so it was a double exposure, but yeah, it's the body metal. His plan was, he had a similar tube like that, and he wanted to get the whole electricity in New York without wires.
That's not the tip of the iceberg. This is not that far-fetched. What he also wanted to realize the entire power supply of the world with his towers, and he started with one of them, and he built a huge tower in one of his laboratories, but it never got fully built because at some point his other people gave him money, got cold feet.
No, it's going to happen the whole evening. Someone is leaving the stage and is looking for something.
Yes, oh, let me just briefly explain about this little box. That's
there it is, that's what I'm looking for.
This little box here is a kit that I got, that I was paid to solder together while I was still working in university. This little box is a storm warning kit that we were gifted after Mr. Pritlov conjured up the thunderstorm at camp.
I'm joking, since ever then we have the thingy with us. We just never used it, and so today we can test it. We bring it close to this Tesla transformator, which will cause some lightning.
It's not doing anything right now. Oh yes, it's glowing ever so slightly, but you have to guess.
Yeah, that's great.
Oh, yellow. Oh, it went from okay, green to amber.
That's great.
The last green light is blinking. Oh no. Oh no, now it went to red.
In other words, if you're 2 centimeters away from a lightning.
If lightning hits this thing, it can tell.
Yeah. Awesome thing. Padawan.
Yes. Boss.
I enjoy this moment so much. It's time to have fire.
Fire? Oh, I'm gonna walk
the stage looking for things. Where is this little? I'll just have a look over
look
there.
For it. In this, there's the chemical in the Sinalco bottle where you're going to talk about.
But wait a sec.
Oh, it's labeled. There's an exclamation mark on it. With a semi-transparent ink.
One has to add, I had 2 bottles to choose from, a water bottle and a Sinalco bottle. I thought the water bottle might be a little confusing because the liquid is transparent, but the color bottle should be safe.
Yeah, but it would have been awesome if you'd left the Fanta logo on it. We'll see.
That's an experiment we also made 2 years ago on the electric staircase.
Didn't we have a larger one? Chemists, look away, please. We're going to pour it back into the original bottle.
The liner was lying next to the Tesla transformator. That's also a good thing.
I know how many times to push the large one so the air can come in, but this one I'm not sure.
Thanks.
Oh, shall we start it off the styrofoam? So in here we have alcohol vapor and hopefully sufficient amounts of air to be able to ignite it. So you all know it, we tried it a couple of years ago. Yeah, no need to warn the cert. We have to get going otherwise. I think we have a larger one, don't we?
Wait, that's just because of the size of the bottle. But scientists like to scale their experiments. And that's awesome. Just prepare the second bottle, please. So I can show you twice. Yeah, respect for Ark, yeah.
Is CERT getting nervous already?
We decided to let it fly anywhere, but what you can observe nicely is the process of formation. Let's have one with and one without. The awesome thing is, we don't care if there are 1,000 people sitting here, we'll just continue.
Okay.
Oh, this one is swaying. There are children here. Now you can play with the light in here.
But please, yeah, the dark variant, please.
Okay, let's see what's happening.
Ah,
okay. I wait for the camera. Expert.
Professional lighter.
But it's not because of us, no. Who's at the switch?
Der ist eingeschlafen.
Okay, hey, fall asleep. Okay, has to be enough. Okay.
Okay. Let's have the other. Can I do this one? Why did I get the one that still has something in it?
Just ask yourself why I'm stepping aside now. Also, this reminds me of something. The disappointment. That much was in there, still? Oh, luckily nothing from safety thing is here.
We need air in there. We need to have air in there, sorry.
We prepared something here.
What's this now?
It's not going to happen in Hall 1.
This wouldn't have been allowed in Hall 1.
Thanks, you are here.
And now the people in Hall 1 are happy.
No, no.
Now we'll
take over this tomorrow. You can see here the inflammation in slow motion. It looks very awesome. You can see first the vapor is inflamed, and then the air is missing, and this is going down cyclic. And that's why you see this pulse inflammation process.
Did I want to tell you about impulse propulsion? Well, some of you build rockets as well, and you may know that the main principle of these pulse engine is that the ignition liquid stays at the bottom and then it draws more air and the whole thing ignites over and over again. A colleague of mine told me this, who built these things in Russia, and he's now married to a Russian girl, actually.
Okay, we need electricity.
So carry on.
Have a look at our homepage from our institute, who has a double name. We want to work in this microwave. We want to have micro experiments which you can repeat at home. Experiments with microwaves are very suitable for this. For those of you who are still living with their parents, yes, I'm talking about you, dear. Don't do this at home.
Not in your home, anyway.
We didn't do this at home. We bought this microwave in Bottrop.
Yeah, eBay small listings. Just go there and look for the cheapest microwave you can find. This costs us, I think, 20 euros, and then there are the two of you, and you ring the doorbell at some weird house, and then a guy in an old t-shirt asks you to come in, and that's when you start wondering if you really need that microwave.
I said outside and had the car running. Why don't we start with this one or the other one? No, we don't do this. We have the other one. Let's have a light bulb.
These are various levels of escalation.
Have you ever worked one of these metalized things?
No, we didn't.
Well, yeah, I can also see it on video.
For the camera crew, maybe stand in front of it. No, don't worry, nothing's going to happen. I'm right beside you. But maybe I should keep my finger somewhere near it. So what do we expect? We expect something to glow because there's usually lower air pressure inside the light bulb, and of course the metal. We'll see.
Oh. It's awesome. Okay, I know. It works.
It works. And it smells a bit funny. Oh, bloody hell, it smells. And it is quite hot. We're losing control.
We had fluffers.
Oh, with these as well. But it's pretty much the same thing.
We want to be jurists, aren't you?
Did you check if it fits? Awesome. So you can use a microwave to actually make some sensible experiments, not just put a light bulb in there like we did, but actually measure things, because on the back of this microwave there is one interesting piece of information.
Where? Made in China, or what do you mean?
Cheap jokes. We can use this microwave to measure the speed of light. How can we do this?
Here, that's a didactic point of this evening. It won't be presented. Oh, thanks to this guy, one in the back of Gavin's didactic.
If you don't know this stuff, it's sugar. Foamed sugar.
Okay. We have a standing wave. A standing microwave in the microwave.
Oh.
We said it's deductive for not literal. That looks just like that. And we can use this. We have points in the microwave where the field is moving heavily, and we have this not points where nothing is happening. If you put something in, that's on me. If you put something in, such as chocolate, then the chocolate is melting, especially at these points where the electromagnetic field is moving the most. We also figured out with chocolate it's not working that well. Basically, Mr. Remford likes fluffer more than chocolate.
This stuff is amazingly disgusting. It's just, it doesn't work with chocolate, unfortunately. You rarely find chocolate of this size.
For a second, I thought you're going to eat this.
Yeah, sure.
A little bit of copper.
Yeah, tastes just like our Mensa. Just like the university canteen. You see this awesome fluffer cream, and it's bright white, and it's just sugar, and it reacts interestingly to heat. Of course, it's not going to turn.
But I say that's also not going to work in hall one, because it's going to smell funny. Do you know how long it takes?
No idea. Just as soon as it burns, it's fine.
It doesn't shine out because we took out the lamp.
Yeah, so you'd see the lamp glow when you put in a lamp.
So, the didactic point is already reached. Well, something's blubbering.
Nah, it's not enough. But it smells good.
I'm just getting something else. Can you do something thematically relevant?
What?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's a difference between him and me. When I'm looking at the next everyone, Herr Remford just took his next beer.
Speaking of which, where's the cab?
It just smells.
Yeah, but it hasn't burnt yet.
That's very close screeching.
But in the meantime, you can tell the audience what we're going to see next. Where's the knife, anyway?
Here it is.
No, a different knife.
In fluff.
Napkins?
That's it? The first row also gets advertised. I think it's okay.
So you explain, I'll prepare.
How you can see.
Eindeutig. Halleluja.
Halleluja.
Zu dem Programmpunkt kommen wir übrigens gleich noch.
This will be a program later on.
Ich mir doch nicht nehmen. Wo ist das Glas? Was für ein Glas?
Which glass?
Where's the jar?
Oh, the jar. Just look for it.
Yeah, you carry on. I'm going to go looking for it.
Okay, just 1 minute, because that's the only equation we're seeing today. Is this one? It's getting harder. See, it's the speed of light is equal to the wavelength times the frequency. The frequency of a microwave is written on the backside. That's what Mr. Remford wanted to say. So 2.45 gigahertz. And the wavelength, we can put it back. We can just measure it. We see this. This makes me crazy.
What?
The wavelength can be measured, because that's the difference, not from one hole to the other, but from one two hole to the, not the next one, but the next after. Yeah, I also realized that. It's of course the one in the first row. We see these points here, and if you measure the distance between these points, if you're not taking this too precisely,
the error bar is about half a ruler's length.
It's about 7 centimeters, as just we said, but we have to take it twice, and then we can put it into the equation, and then we have speed of light is 1.14. Meters times the frequency of 2.54 gigahertz, and then we get 343
million meters per second.
That is pretty close to the speed of light. Isn't it? This means we measured the speed of light with this thingy.
Amazing.
And my hand got sticky. Another thing is, we have this microwave in different stages of escalation, and
this is the most awesome one with biscuit and grapes.
I once made a science slam, and also as a Remford does this, the topic was about we used a microwave source to make diamonds. Of course, it was not of this one, it was more high-tech.
Well, if you try hard enough, we could probably make it work with this one.
You're also one of these guys I want to talk about. If you do the science slams, so once in a month you get a call, hey Vern, we saw this very interesting talk of you, and we'd love to do the same. We do have a microwave, and we would love to do diamonds. Yeah, at least once a month I get an email or a call. And I'm like, did they just saw the science slam to the slide, or maybe a little bit further? Because in the science slam you have this slide as a concept sketch.
As silly as this sounds, we met somebody at a Daimler conference who had no idea of research, but thinks it's pretty awesome what we're doing here synthetically. And he just bought lots of stuff of eBay, and now he's building one of these diamond machines in his garage.
Why is he not here tonight?
That is a good question.
Please?
I didn't get a ticket, yeah.
Okay. What I want to say long story short, diamonds in such a microwave is not as easy, but what we can do is doing plasma, not only in bulbs, but just with materials, Reiner just said, that's pretty awesome. So we're going to try this.
Well, we're going to try. This is the kind of experiment that usually works one time out of 10. We tried it with this glass 3 times, and it worked 3 times out of 3 last time, so that's pretty magic. So what we did is we took a grape, we cut it in two, but it's still ever so, you know, it's still attached by the tiniest bit, and the biscuit is in there as well, and then there's a piece of tissue in there, so we get a bit more soot as soon as we create the plasma, and all the soot and the carbon is a bit more easy to ionize because it's simply air. I'm interested to see if it's going to work or not, because I just built it off the top of my head.
If you look at it, it's definitely an experiment of methodical incorrect. Let's have a look.
No, that didn't work.
Did it light up? But not as we want to have it.
We had a second glass as well, didn't we?
Switch back to the slides, please. Then we can explain in principle. We have the electromagnetic field, which is hidden here. And a charge is in this thing, follow the field. Also in this bridge in between. And it's a very short way, and many electrons which are going to do it, and therefore it's getting hot, and it's going to burn up. And that's why we have put also the piece of paper, and this, the carbon is very easy to ionize, and therefore we hope there is a plasma in this glass.
We have 3 attempts, and if it doesn't work on the 3rd try, then we have video. Not looking too good.
Is it maybe because you're doing this wrong that round?
Yeah, could be, but might also be because we have different grapes than we had last time.
Where do you buy them?
I don't want to say it was Rewe.
The last ones were from Lidl, haven't they?
I don't remember.
That's my wife, not you. So if you ever want to do a plasma in a microwave, the grapes from Lidl are the better ones. I don't have that much to tell anymore. Or we can just show the video. Will this be of any help?
Nee, lass mal das hier probieren. Und wenn das nicht geht, let's try this one. And if this doesn't work, then switch to the video.
Yeah, me as well. Should we maybe try the other glass again?
Should I try the other glass?
I'll just have a look.
Hurry.
Oh, so this is something which reminds me of so.
Just give me. Oh, that's dirty.
Always this tense silence.
I'm sorry, but the glass is still okay. That's what we actually wanted to show.
Well, you can see the flame in the lower right, and that's the grape, and the paper that's around it, and that starts burning. And on top, there is an ionization happening, and that's the plasma you create in the microwave. And the colors tell you what kind of gas it is.
We see yellow here, so it's a lot of nitrogen, which is what air is consisting of mostly. Now this is my favorite.
Well,
we have to
take care of that soon.
We want to show a phenomenon what you certainly know, beer tapping. the physics of beer tapping, and this is called.
You all know that. You have two bottles of beer, and you bump one on the top of the other, and the whole thing foams over. And we've got a wonderful video of that. And if you look at it in slow motion, then, well, somewhere in the liquid, you spontaneously get bubbles of carbon dioxide.
Can we put this guy in another place? There are long cables and short cables. Can we put this somewhere else? Can we disconnect and put this somewhere else?
Yeah, just away. That'd be great. Well,
thank you.
Mr. Remford.
Yes.
Just, you know, speak about this a little.
Yes. This phenomenon that you can hit one beer bottle with the other and the upper one will run over and the lower one. This was researched, and this is called physics of beer tapping. And people researched why the lower bottle runs over. And the reason is that the hit of the upper bottle causes a pressure wave in the lower bottle, and this pressure wave will be reflected up, and this is an expansion wave. This wave will run up again and will then be reflected down, and this is compression wave will be reflected up and down, etc., etc. And expansion waves happens with the oxide
causes the carbon dioxide bubbles to sort of breathe and grow and get smaller and grow smaller until they burst. And when that happens, the ratio of surface to volume suddenly change, and suddenly all the small bubbles get much, much bigger than the mother bubble, and then suddenly they sort of absorb all the carbon dioxide from the surrounding beer, and they grow immensely, and suddenly they start rising, and you get these nuclear mushroom-like explosion in the beer, and through this expansion they can get closer to more CO2, and they can grow more, and then you get a huge freaking mess.
And we thought we'd show this to you, and we can also look at this closer. If you have understood this principle once, why the CO2 is so separated out of this liquid, you can speed up this whole process. And because we have pressure waves...
Well, we're going to start with this one.
We start with this one, okay. If our beer bottle... If we put the beer bottle in a hypersonic... Path. Then we also produce these shock waves, but not only once, but a few thousand times a second. And we can assume that all the CO2 that is solved, that is in the beer, wants to escape in like half a second. I never tried this before, by the way.
Moment.
Yeah. One moment, please. That happens with beer.
We've talked about scaling things up today. It's that time again.
May I?
Do you want to unwrap it, or should I do it?
Go ahead.
All right.
In Prosec, there is a little more CO2 compared to beer.
I seriously hope that it's not going to just burst.
Even if it does,
it's going to burst afterwards, but it shouldn't burst out yet. Let's carefully. Oh, well, that wasn't it yet.
No problem.
No. Yeah, this
not an old one.
Yeah. Now I'm gonna need some sort of exit. We tried it last in my garden, and people weren't happy. It's going to get
eventually
messy.
Eventually, we need a few angels. We hope the most of the stuff goes back into the bath.
That's very naive from my experience.
So let's go.
We can't put the cork back in there. Well, in my case, that went quite a bit higher. But still.
Probably not enough water.
We've had that higher, but no worries. But that actually has a real importance.
Indeed, even if this sounds like stupid research.
For us.
This behavior of COT has real meaning. This is Lake Nios, or however you called it in Cameroon. That one is
oversaturated.
Oversaturated with CO2. And because of volcanic activities, lots of CO2 was salt.
And once every few decades, all of this CO2 is released in an explosion style, just like we showed with this Prosecco bottle. And that's got really sad consequences. And the last time, about 1,700 people died because of the CO2 that rose, sort of displaced all the air, and people died. So sad. Carry on.
Wow.
And that's how he hands it over to me.
Why do I always have the sad scenes?
So now we get to something really funny, which is religion. You remember that was a gift from a listener, and actually only after we showed up here and I had so much fun, I informed myself on Amazon and looked at the reviews, how people like it.
Where do I put it?
The reviews are amazing, just like that one. How do I get people closer to the Flying Spaghetti Monster? As an fanatic pastafarian, I can, with the help of this book, show kids, the youngest of kids, that pastafarianism has real roots. This one's also pretty good. Early bird catches a worm is also true if you're trying to be a religion. And
how to implant religion in children's heads so critical question will not appear.
And that's how you get one more church tax paying little sheep. I am very happy to announce that there is a part two, and that's this book.
Didn't you want to preach first?
No. First we have to show the experiment. This is the second part. It's still called Tried It and Found God. And I found a wonderful experiment, and that's the oil bubble.
Oil sphere,
yes, thank you. And I mean, yeah. Children's book. We've got everything here we need. And I'm going to read out and...
Why are there only Russian signs on this one?
So we're going to need a bottle that's half filled with water. Just, you know, type that one, but it doesn't have to be the half of it. We're going to ignore the ink. We're going to put 3 tablespoons of oil into it and try holding it so that my wife doesn't see it, because that's the expensive one. There's, you know, included chilies, and they really shouldn't get in there. 3 tablespoons. That's good.
Yep.
So, next step is important, I think.
Nun wird ein ganzer Schluck Alkohol, Gesundheit, ein ganzer Schluck Alkohol in die Flasche.
Now we insert a whole gulp of alcohol into the bottle. I'm really not sure what alcohol means here, they didn't specify. So we're going to put vodka Putinov in there. I'm also not sure what a little gulp is. That's pretty brave, given how I label my bottles. Can you still see?
More colors than you.
Okay, a little gulp.
Into the bottle, please. Yes. Chemists wouldn't label this correctly.
Yeah, even safety more? Officers would.
So, staunen. Also ich lese mal vor, warum wir jetzt staunen. Wenn die ersten Tropfen Alkohol auf das Öl
when the first drops of alcohol hit the oil, you get a little crater, and then when you insert more, the sheet of oil droops and you get a little
sphere
that is suspended in the liquid.
Use even more of the Russian one.
Okay. All right. I'm going to take the other one. We're going to take this Russian gift that I got in Belarus.
From the university where our professor... This looks like the blood of Christ.
I'm going to propose that we read the religious interpretation here.
One moment, please.
And then we're going to look at what this tells us about us and our faith. So, my friends.
One moment.
I'm just going to start preaching.
Yeah, just start preaching.
I've been really looking forward for a whole year here so I can lean over this. The explanation of this experiment has to do with the density of the liquids, and the oil is less dense than the water, so it swims on the water, and the alcohol is even less dense. And this experiment can serve to can be explained with a biblical quote.
So, ein bisschen Konzentration hier mal. Während mein Heiligenschein zusammenfällt.
Ja, warte, ich komme wieder. A little bit of concentration while my Corona collapses here. The oil swims up above, which represents Jesus in heaven. That's his place, that's where he belongs, and that's where he's close to God. But then something changes. God's plan is for Jesus to descend to earth, and Jesus does that, gets pissed and sloshed, and goes down to earth. He becomes a human. And this human life of Jesus begins with his birth, and we're just going to skip that. And God has changed. He's really close to all of us as long as we're drinking liquid. He became human. By looking at the oil spheres in the bottle, we can remember that God came down to us because he loved us and gave us alcohol. But now I ask you, what does this tell us? Didn't all of us drink too little? God comes to us through alcohol, obviously. Yes, cheers. I've done this experiment twice, and it hasn't worked twice. It just kind of fits the whole concept of this book.
Only my faith is missing.
So, it's time, friends.
Oh, yeah, right.
For, you know, the thing we get most of the criticism for.
One essential experiment of our podcast, where we are criticized often, and this is not the bashing of the AfD, that's the second most criticism.
It's the music. But, you know, we're going to continue with our concept, and you are going to have to bear with us for bad music, and we found something on the internet.
Do wannabe rappers?
Well, I think they also do a sort of podcast.
We need the sound of the laptop as loud as possible.
Let's drop the beat here.
As loud as possible.
Yo, shut up. This is Mincorrect talking with the dialect from the Ruhrpott. Doppler effect you didn't understand. Are you listening to Mincorrect here? Come to the Congress, come to Hamburg.
And get your nitrogen.
Here is the science battling, and only Mincorrect is setting the... there's no paywalls. Only if you're listening to Mincorrect, you're learning something. You've got too much beer, send it to Mincorrect. You want experiments? Listen to Mincorrect. We are Mincorrect. We are Mincorrect. I'm not a rapper, I really apologize. Nix not show. We're
Mincorrect. Dear. This will be awesome.
Don't worry about fire protection. We've got gadgets from way beyond the border. We just do everything with it. I'm
Mincorrect fucks you, nature, science.
Paywalls.
For security, for safety, Mincorrect even has a PhD.
Sorry, we're gonna give up at this point for the song. We heavily apologize, but this is beyond our ability.
We see the first people in the crowd waving their hands.
Zeigerbretter, lad's komplett, wir zeigen wie. Der Boss im Darknet Mincorrect. Mincorrect ist höflich und das immer pünktlich. Gibt's leider nicht schriftlich. Mincorrect macht's möglich. Mincorrect macht nur, was Mincorrect will. Wissenschaftliche Sensationen und albernster Müll. Wenn du frech wirst, holen wir nicht SEK. Mincorrect twittert und kurz danach sind Ultras da. Ultras aus Sachsen, Ultras aus Bayern kommen zum Kongress, um hier mit uns zu feiern. Lutsch an der Diodenwurst, jetzt siehst du Sterne. Sicherung gibt's nicht, Mincorrect grillt gerne. Mund auf, Schunk rein, 48 Stunden wacht, die Glühgurke brennt hell, macht die ganze Nacht zum Tag. Mincorrect hat Fanshirts, tragen sie wie Uniform. Gegen parawissenschaftliche Bullshit sind Fanshirts wie Protektor. Stickstoff in Flasche, Deckel drauf, Mincorrect hat Spaß und das Allerbeste. Mincorrect darf das. Du willst etwas lernen, dann hör Mincorrect. Du hast Hörerfragen, dann frag Mincorrect. Du hast zu viel Bier, schickes Mincorrect. Du hast nasses Höschen, blinkt ab Mincorrect. Wir sind 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 Mincorrect. Mincorrect hat Ahnung und Schunk-Superkraft. Methodisch inkorrekt, schafft Wissen mit Wissenschaft. Mincorrect ist sexy. Mincorrect hat Top-Inhalt. Mincorrect hat letztes Jahr das Rednerpult abgeknallt. Mincorrect hat Fanshop. Mincorrect macht viel Spaß. Mincorrect heißt Reinhold. Reinhard und Nikolas. Mincorrect ist vorn dabei. Der wird Trendsetter. Mincorrect ist dein Gott. Mincorrect dein Retter.
We're gonna pick up translating from here again. We do apologize, but that was a bit much.
Maybe there should be live rap battle translation.
Does somebody want to have this gangster cap? So,
we hope you didn't suffer too much.
So, after the music, we usually have the bit about the China gadgets. That was, did we do that last year? I don't think we did. We just had that.
Did we have that just? Yeah, we just had that. That's if you have Chokmangel, if you don't have enough Chok.
It's our chunk emergency signal.
Okay. Ich probier's mal so eher in die Richtung. Ihr habt die Dinger vielleicht.
I'm gonna try this more in this direction. If you have seen this one, these things, these are often used in
pedestrian areas and sold to little kids.
You fire these if you don't have enough chunk. So it's amazing that this is sold to children in the streets. Yeah, that worked more or less. Yeah, this is what we had, a blue light that... Yeah, it's blue. The chunk emergency signal should show if there is not enough chunk. Yeah, I am also don't have enough chunk. The problem with this blue signal was that...
So, first I have to say that this was, you know, accepted by you. We saw that in a few pedestrian areas, and we got that like four days ago in a pedestrian area in Hamburg. Somebody spotted it there.
Yes, and you have problems with that. As you just saw, this thing is very short, has a very short lifespan. So, you would have to like alcohol, but this is not really satisfying. So a China gadget like this is not really, it's very cheap.
We got our head designer and talked to him and said, you know, We've got to get active here. And ladies and gentlemen, we would proudly present the Chunk emergency signal 2.0.
The best one we ever built.
It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous.
We have always thought of design as being so much more than just the way something looks. It's the whole thing. The way something actually works on so many different levels. Ultimately, of course, design defines so much of our experience. I think there is a profound and enduring beauty in simplicity, in clarity, in efficiency. True simplicity is derived from so much more than just the absence of clutter and ornamentation. It's about bringing order to complexity.
The Chunk Emergency Signal 2.0
is a clear representation of these goals. It has a whole new structure that is coherent and that is applied across the entire system. We wanted to take an experience that people know very well and actually add to it, to make it more useful, to make it more enjoyable.
Well,
yeah.
And now?
Wait a sec. Yeah, just a moment.
And now we are proud to present Chunk Emergency Signal 2.0. Es geht sogar an.
It actually turns on.
This is a gadget that we got from China for 50 cents.
Das geht aber wirklich, das ist ja irre.
that actually works. It's crazy. Actually, you know, lift it up here. Nobody can see it here. I actually put it up there so people could see it, you know? I actually wanted to tell a funny story about that.
Oh, yeah. How we bought this thing.
On the 23rd, we were in Essen in a balloon shop. Have you ever been to a balloon shop? It's actually quite funny.
They sell balloons. There is a whole shop for just balloons. And they don't measure helium in liters, but in balloon volumes. Balloon volumes. If you buy helium from them, they ask how many balloons. And then you say, it's like a medium balloon, like 50 liters. And they ask, how many balloons? All they ask you is how many balloons. So yeah, there is indeed a shop where you can only buy balloons.
I think we just said that. We just have to be careful here, you know.
Chunk emergency signal 2.0 works.
It works, Reinhard. close your ears. This is gonna hurt.
You have to do this if you have helium, or right?
So, genug dazu.
Enough of that. Let's talk about the sad thing of today's talk.
What was that supposed to be, Reinhard?
We took part in a small experiment which had something to do with passing on data. We have a CD player here. The older people will know what that is. There were these round silver discs with which you could play music, and then we have a
speaker, and you can use that to listen to it. And
we have an amplifier, and this you can buy
for way too much money at Puvo, the teaching pharmacy.
Yeah. And I don't remember how exactly this works, but this adapter, this Chinch adapter.
If you are going to ask, does somebody know speakers here? I'm gonna, you know.
No, you know the one that was supposed to be here.
That one there. I'm just gonna plug this in.
We should probably have done this before. This is just mono. Then one is enough.
Do you remember, do we have 8 ohms? Oh, no, wait.
Well,
input.
Input is, that makes sense, right? Where's the second one? We have another one, right?
Right now, the questions of Mr. Renford are leaving you, you know, unexcited, but you'll see.
Can you look at this? Yeah, 8 ohm, right?
I can take a look at the thingy. We haven't got a circuit plan of that thing. I mean,
it will work.
Yeah.
How was this again? I really don't remember how this works.
I'm going to give you a moment there and just, you know, talk about it a little. So, we had help from someone who helped us bring the plop. And he asked me today, you know, were you serious about that CD player? You're not just doing that to, like, play a sound file. That's going to be more to that. And I told him, of course, yes, it's not just about any CD. This is a big moment for me.
I don't know if this is the right way to connect the cables here. Is there power? Yeah, there's power.
That reminds me of the gigs of my band.
I powered it on.
Okay, this is the disc. It feels like when we used to give
the CD player.
We used to do concerts, and it's still just as quiet, really. Okay, so it's as I feared, just a little bit chaotic, you know.
It will be fine. Wait a minute, this goes in here, this goes in here. Oh, unfortunately I have it in my hand.
So, the biggest crowd that has ever had this music played to them was like 15 people.
This is running?
So I wanted to pick one of the good songs.
We have to see if this runs
really
at all. And there
aren't
are
any good songs on this disc. I'm not hearing anything. The CD player is running, right? Yeah.
The I have to pull trigger the switch in the box. This is embarrassing.
We're failing at the speaker.
This is the exit with 5 kilo ohms, but this doesn't seem to be a problem.
Did I hear useful tips over there?
If you put this together, there will be a poof, and then the cows will
tip
follower.
The cows will tip over. If you put it together the wrong way.
Well, this goes here. This goes here. Oh yeah, the mass is missing there.
That's a good tip.
This should go here, and this should go here, right? Well, I still don't hear anything. Yeah, and this, you put this back there, and I still don't hear anything. Well, we seem to fail. Does this run? We actually fail here.
Come on, you're just sabotaging my music.
No, seriously, no. I don't know how it looked like.
That should have been the high point of my musical career.
I'm very sorry.
It's unbelievable.
There is not so many things that you can hide here, right?
Oh. This harmonious sound. Oh no, that's not the good one. I'm just gonna pick something else.
This is not very spectacular. This is just music, and this is just bad music.
So what we actually want to show you is
dass man diese Verbindung lösen kann. Genau. Und diese Musik, hältst du mal den? Diese Musik geht wortwörtlich durch Mark und Bein, wenn man möchte.
This music actually goes through marrow and bone, if you want to. You gotta get closer to it with the mic. Actually, wait, that's much more... That feels much better. We'd actually like to try that with a couple of people and like make a circle and the whole first row.
Please come up, just the first row, please.
Yeah, get up.
And the last person, please give your hand to me.
Let's hold hands. So
the nice thing is that the music now goes through so many people.
As many hearts as never before.
So this music did not ever touch so many hearts. Not in a positive way.
Oh, that's how nice. So how does this work? Because of the human body consisting mostly of water and a couple of salts, but mostly it's a pretty okay electric conductor. Typically about 100 ohm between the hands. So if you have enough power, the signal goes through and we can listen to the music. So, that was my rock and roll moment. Of course, I dreamed of moments like these.
Where are the lighters?
Oh,
yeah, here.
Over in Hall 1, that's what they tell me. Well, I mean, that would be pretty badass.
I'm just going to throw this into the crowd. And pass them through the back, please.
Yeah, but you know, unpack them.
Because you want to, for her well, because musician career is not going to happen. At least you want to give him the feeling of a sea of flames. You want to show you something different that we brought with us.
Did you
make sides for this?
No, that's everything, really.
What we brought with us is a trash can with a bit of plastic at the back. Oh, look at that. That's cute.
a lighter app. You can't get more romantic in this century.
More romantic, yep.
The smoke detectors are off here, right?
Yeah, go on.
Yeah, you can't do that either
in
Hall 1. It's my rock and roll moment.
I want to see the lighters, please. Oh.
Oh, wow. All those smokers.
We try with a... We try to put the lighters out with a... With a pressure wave, with an air pressure wave. Oh, Gandalf.
Oh, I hit one. You turned it off, right? Oh, no. I don't.
The first haircut is ruined.
Gonna need more ammo.
Does this compensate for the concerts where only two people came?
I'm thinking about doing stage diving here.
Okay, einmal noch. Wobei, viel geiler war eigentlich dieser Ring, der da durchs Licht geflogen ist, ne? Da muss man nochmal.
Boah! Du warst nicht beim Bund, oder?
You didn't go to the army, right?
Mach die Feuerzeuge aus, das war eine scheiß Idee, aber hier mit dem Beamer. Turn off the lighters, that was a stupid idea.
It's beautiful.
But maybe I can hit the Beamer.
Mal kurz Didaktik, warum funktioniert das so geil?
So let me teach you, why does this work so amazingly? We're about to get in trouble again. So this works beautifully because we have this lens here that we put into the trash can. And that leads to the air in the middle being ejected very quickly and being slowed down at the edges. And if you look at this image, the air in the middle is quicker and it's slower at the edges, and then it's drawn in by the pull of the faster moving air, and that creates this sort of torus of smoke. And you don't just see that with smoke and air, but you can also see it in the animal kingdom, and dolphins play with this, and they use the same principle to create rings from air underwater, and that's quite interesting. The dolphin always, you know, catches one of the rings out of the big ring and keeps playing. It's actually pretty crazy. Well, yes, and yeah. And, of course, we have to honor one of the greatest smoke ring blowers that another world has seen, and that, of course, is Bilbo Baggins. And don't forget Gandalf, who, you know, takes this to another level, so to speak.
This will be a night to remember.
Yeah, I weiß, können wir noch umdrehen.
Herr Remford? Ja?
Mr. Remford?
No. The just able to take the other direction because this one is perfect and...
Yeah, we can switch that later. So we've got a few more experiments with liquid nitrogen.
This is also a case for our sign. This is not going to work in Saal 1.
An hour of bearing with shitty experiments just so we can do a big bang.
What you can see here are... You can forget the other ones. They're just...
No. We wanted to do the thing with the bags.
What you can see here are wearable U's. Which was stick on a battery. We didn't think it would survive that long. But water is not as conductive as I thought.
Yeah, that's super. I just said the opposite of that.
That's how science works sometimes. I just showed them in.
Where are those actually, now that you mentioned them? Well, that's actually more like preparation.
I hope the balloons will survive. I just put them thinner because they won't fit more.
That's actually, you know, going to be fairly boring. And the people who've been sitting here for 3 talks can just
pee as well.
Go have a shit. We're just not gonna do that much more, just more like 10 minutes
yes,
more.
Yes, I do notice. They're here.
Oh yeah, there. So then,
do we have to put something there as well?
Water, yes.
I want to tell something about ice. It's a little bit experiment, which also has a funny historical background, because in World War II, I suppose, Churchill, etc., they thought about having a ship made of ice.
An aircraft carrier,
thank you.
That was called Project Habakkuk. Let's go back to the slides. And yeah, there.
Project Habakkuk. They were literally thinking about to build one of the things made of ice, which would be unthinkable. As mentioned, it sounds very stupid at first point, but it has some very interesting properties. When you have one of these ice blocks, you can destroy them very easily. And that's what I want to show you here. I'll put some more around it. You know, it cracks when you hit it. But if you add wood or some paper, the ice block will be very hard. It will be hard to destroy it. And the ship which they wanted to buy, it will be the same principle. They wanted to add wood, and it will be normally indestructible. Just like Titanic. We need water.
We are going to use Jesus.
It's water and not alcohol, isn't it?
Yeah, sure. It's Jesus as he is in heaven with his father.
I think it's enough. I think pretty fast, that's why we have the nitrogen.
Do you need some more water?
Yeah, I need more water for the ice block. We need a second control experiment.
Is that with gas? Yeah.
Yeah, that's stupid.
No,
there's no gas in there. It's ice in here. So number 2, we'll try to have an ice block out of this. Let's see how it is going. Oh, it's cracking here.
How far are our LEDs, actually? Oh, yeah. Nothing's glowing there, is there? Do you see anything? We can...
Oh, we wanted to have lightning cubes of balls of ice. I tried to remove this outer shell.
It's another experiment we haven't tried out first. It's quite surprising, isn't it?
I well thought a tongue is sticking there, but my fingers, ouch!
The safe treatment of cryogenic liquids. You're just gonna put that there? I'm just gonna do what I can, you know?
Look if there's something blinking still.
Yeah, Oh, we can see a little weak glow. Maybe if we turn off the lights. Let's put it like this. We were planning for something more spectacular. You can see we had high expectations.
We can make a rocket out of nitrogen. Come, that's cool. That's nice.
If we don't have anything better, might as well.
We had it the last time, but it's very beautiful. And once you have nitrogen, and as long we have to wait for the other ice.
I mean, we're kind of like these rundown folk singers. It's just, you know, no better ideas. Bring back the old.
Oh, sorry. Ouchie.
Well, yeah.
Das auch das wieder das Prinzip einer Wasserrakete nur Stickstoff getrieben.
It's again the same principle as a water rocket, but this time with nitrogen. You maybe remember this from last time.
Wow.
Did I catch that on video?
Shrug. The answer is a shrug.
No.
Yeah.
We promise we're not destroyed too much. We promise to
Yeah, come on. Just one more time. We're gonna do it one more time.
That's really out of boundaries.
Yeah.
We got in a bit of trouble because we said we wanted to do something at the closing ceremony with liquid nitrogen, and then they said, well, there is space on underneath, and if something flows down and somebody's below that stage, then that's going to get tricky for the person below, so you can't do that. And so we have this PET bottle, and you know, nothing goes wrong. So you're gonna try it straight up.
Okay,
so enough of that.
Okay, back to our experiment.
Oh yeah, I brought it along. So let's talk about Project Habakkuk some more, which the Mr. Remford reenacted here. I'm going to show you a serving suggestion, and that's what it was supposed to look like.
Because I was looking for something where you could put it on.
Okay.
Maybe I just take this one.
Yeah, now I know why I let
cold,
you do
it?
All of this all the time. Oh, ow. Is that one with the pulp?
Nope, that's just ice. That's just ice. It's very spectacular. If you just track it, it just breaks.
It just breaks.
It breaks.
Yep, it breaks. So, I mean, that's a bit, you know, pity. Shit, that's cold.
Stop complaining that much.
Come on, it's really bad.
I usually do this. It's our fiber supported ice. I hope it will take more. Because basically that's the principle of this fiber-supported materials. Because the material itself is semi-hard, but because of these fibers, it can take much. I can really...
Did we point out enough that there was just, you know,
you can really
pieces of paper in there?
It. It's not going to happen. Just because of this paper material in there, this ice gets very stable. Because once the ice gets frozen, it gets a crystal, and when you crack it, this cracks go around and crack. So, and when these fibers are in there, the crack is stopped. So it can't deconstruct the whole crystal, and that's why the ice gets stable. And that's exactly the principle of this fiber-supported polymer things.
I'm not feeling my fingers anymore. So, let's get to the closing experiment of this evening.
Yeah, very sorry.
So, where did we put the kitchen roll? So, I'm going to look for the... here.
So, we bought this just in a shop. So it's just a regular instruction from internet. We shorted it a little bit because you weren't sure about gun laws in Germany.
What's the young man saying? Well, you can't do that in Hall 1, and yes, you're right.
Wir haben jetzt hier eine Konfetti-Beschleunigungseinrichtung.
We have a confetti accelerator here. It's perfectly legal.
Yeah.
If you want to know, I can tell you how you do this. Of course, it's not enough. It's unofficial, etc., etc. So you don't have, are not to do this again. We have here a big, we just fill something flammable. In this case, I think it's Ox Dark.
So. We're going to demonstrate this. I think I should maybe have removed the paper. So, okay, so I'm going to load this.
We're going to demonstrate this in an open way, so to show you how it's happening. Earlier this day, I completely burned the hair on my arm.
So now he remembers what he tattooed on his arm in 1989.
I think he waited too long. There's still something burning.
So, say this again. On principle, you know, it's...
I think the principle's clear. So now we're going to load it. It smells nice, isn't it? And you thought the sausage was very bad. So we're going to load it with a little paper.
And then we get back to the moment.
We're already saying sorry not once, the angels we have to clean up here.
And we have never tried this before. Our experiments usually have some sort of error tolerance. And this experiment has got by far the biggest. We tried it once without confetti, and the barrel was longer.
And it was slightly louder.
And this is probably the best we can do in the closed hall.
We advise you to close shut your ears. He was going to close my ears. You're deaf on one side anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah. So, the error tolerance is pretty big. It was very loud, and then we tried it another time, or saw other people do it, and that just didn't work.
That's another thing about it, isn't it?
Well, yeah. Of course, that was really the subject of the evening. We don't know what's going to happen.
What I learned today is next time we'll take the instructions with us.
Yeah, that was a bit embarrassing.
But we're not electricians. So. Mr. Remscheid is electrician, isn't he?
So, take care of your ears.
Take care of your ears.
That's what I meant about error tolerance. Wow. Yeah, again. Yes, I get it.
I can do this again.
Yeah, of course we can do that one more time. But don't have too high hopes that it's going to get better.
Me neither.
Now it's gonna get dangerous, and we've got paper in there, and we've got, you know, nitrogen and hydrogen and
helium. I never used this word.
I never talked about a pressure container here. Just, you know, to have said that. Should we try the ethanol? We really don't know what's going to happen. So just don't listen for a second. I mean, what can happen?
Goes away.
Worst case, it's just gonna poof. Yes, I know. Do you think we should do
but
that?
But then we still have to load confetti in there.
Er macht sich. Sehr schön. Oxidiert ganz langsam durch, habe ich gehört.
It's gonna just rust slowly.
Dann.
Well, ethanol or just, again, the... All right, we're going to try the ethanol. The bad thing is, this isn't a joke. We didn't try this before. There was a suggestion of just using it as a vacuum.
That's enough.
Why
do I have this in my hands? And now we're right again in the story.
With the
this flammable
mixture. With a flammable mixture. Not enough air. Give me a sec.
I think with the Deo it was better. Of course!
I'm gonna go fetch the deodorant.
Yep. You also need air. Nope.
Yeah, okay. Deodorant it is. It's a life lesson, you know. When in doubt, use deodorant. So, you know, that's gonna be a really sad end if that doesn't work out here. We should burn it off empty. No. All right.
We're very sorry.
But thanks a lot. This was methodically wrong from the Congress, and thank you for being here. Wait. Wait. Calm. Don't just run away. You're going to miss something. The point is, I was being driven crazy about from day zero that we would, you know, overdraw by half an hour, and now you only use 10 minutes more. So, you know, we're going to do this like any other talk. You may ask questions. Well, crap. You know, there's mics, three of them. Go get them.
Ja, dann fangen wir an da vorne.
Wir könnten das mit dem Ethanol doch. Oh, das Mikrofon macht es selbstständig. Das mit dem Ethanol doch nochmal ausprobieren, wenn wir einfach das Konfettirohr an die großen Wasserkanister, die ihr.
We could try the thing with the ethanol if you just connect the confetti tube to the big water containers that you had before.
Ja, das können wir gerne machen. Yes, we could do this, but we have to close down the stream beforehand, please.
Hier vorne?
Here in front? What's actually the beer of the week?
That's a very good question. A question's up to you. The four beers which have been here, they were being brought from this gentleman down there. It's a Ratsherrn Rotbier. That's the beer of the week.
Bitteschön.
Würde sich bei der Konfettikanone nicht noch ein bisschen Nitrous Oxide als
Oxidant würde sich nicht noch wouldn't Nitrous Oxide be a good accelerant for the confetti cannon?
And you are holding it in your hands.
Mich für alles zu haben. Nein, tatsächlich, ohne Scheiß, wir haben die wirklich, wir haben die bei Nikolas im Garten
auch. In fact, we have tried that at Nikolas' garden, and it was like half nine, and it was so freaking loud. And it was a little bit longer, and we didn't use it with this problem, it was empty, and then it's just way louder.
Die ist jetzt halt nicht mehr besonders. Wir können die mal kurz mal, aber
we can try this, but it's not that loud anymore. Because we shorten it that much.
Wir haben die vorhin noch mal auf dem
ich wollte so gerne daneben stehen.
I wanted to be close.
We tried it at the balcony just a bit ago and it's really
it's quite more quiet because it's shorter.
You see, it's sad. It was louder before, wasn't it? Yeah, it's about a humidity in this room. We can optimize that for next year. Because first we had in mind that we can throw around sausages.
And maybe we do this next year.
That was the first idea. That you got out of the safety thingies. Oh, we can take a vegan sausage if you want to. And if the question is, yes, we did indeed study physics.
Actually, I wanted to ask where you could get the CD.
You get this if you have a
pre-stamped envelope sent via air.
And everything I wanted to read pigeon. For today, we can stop it now.
One more question. Perhaps you could combine the thing with the water and the
liquid nitrogen and the potato.
And the potato gun.
We have never talked about a potato gun here. That was a confetti gun. That's a complete different thing. At least I hope so.
Legally, it's a different thing.
It was a confetti accelerator, not a confetti gun.
Not a potato gun.
A potato gun, sorry.
This is important.
Der Herr in Grün, irgendwo hier waren doch auch diese Aufkleber just for anal use, oder?
Was? Somewhere here there were these stickers just for anal use. So I've got a proposal for holding the thing with the liquid nitrogen and everything, and you could just, you know, tape it to the table.
It's not that a bad idea, I guess. Yeah, liquid nitrogen? And it's tight enough.
We're going to try that out now. It doesn't expand
like explosively.
Da hinten zeigt so ein Engel rot auf. Möchtest du was sagen?
Ja, ich habe eine Frage aus dem IAC.
So there's a question from the internet. What could the glass have to do anything about the plasma in the microwave?
Because it depends on the glass, because of the thickness, so the electromagnetic waves have to get through. And what I think is, it also depends on the height. Because the gases in there, they have to collect in there, on top of the glass. And if this point is just at one point, where we have a maximum of the electromagnetic field,
High field strength.
Then the plasma is going to start rightly. The glass you use fused, then you're just a little
shorter,
short to the maximum of this electromagnetic field. It's geometry and also the walls.
You really have to hit that spot where the field is strongest, and that matters a lot, and then you get a really nice plasma. And next time, you know, we can just leave the experiments and just have a physical discussion. But let's fill this first.
Okay, jetzt halte ich hier das Loch zu.
So I hold this close?
Yeah.
Das ist das, was Herr Remford gerade meinte. That was Herr Remford wanted to say.
It doesn't decompress explosively.
I just hear myself saying, that's a good idea.
Was sagte der Mann? Oh. Aber hier ist Konfetti, müssen wir nochmal reinmachen.
We have to add a new confetti.
Es sieht doch schlimmer aus, als ich dachte.
It looks worse than I thought.
Als ich sagte, wir brauchen zwei Engel, um zu aufzuräumen.
It looks worse than I thought, as I said, we need two angels to clean all the selling hubs.
Ja, da ist noch drin. Ist noch drin.
Yeah, the watch is still in there.
And we also have to pack it very dense.
Yeah, we have to...
We can make water, then nitrogen, and then shake it.
We have to seal it tight.
I can't hear me again, it's a good idea.
Okay.
You do realize you're turning ever more into our professor.
I'm not saying it's a good idea. First we need water.
But first... Yeah.
And also figure out the hole.
We have to... Do we want to tape it close?
Yes. He's a hacker.
All these hackers all the time. It's... Did somebody ever build that at camp? Be honest about this. So what do we put in there? Water. Yeah, water.
We'll take lots of it.
Plenty of water. Just put that in there. What's that actually there? Something frozen. Where's the cover? We should think about this. You know, we just take everything along and you tell us what to do. I mean, clearly we just need the raw material.
That saves time in preparation.
Yeah. Do you ever think we can ever get life insurance again?
So, any ideas with 20,000 volts?
Someone, any ideas, please? We've got 5 minutes left, you know.
Now it's the last turn to hold it.
Which video? Oh, the intro.
Oh, the intro video.
No, we're not going to do that again.
We've got something nice
for closing ceremony. Yeah, we built something for that, yeah.
The question was, could you please put something in the microwave again?
Well, we are actually out of nitrogen.
Helium in a microwave is just boring. Nothing's gonna happen there.
Vielleicht können wir mal ausprobieren, durch wie viele Leute das durchgeht mit dem Signal und.
Das machen wir mal.
We could try how many people we can use for the signal transmission as we used it before. And it's actually a good idea. So the synthesis starts with a hypothesis. And helium is easier to ionize than air. And if we put helium in one of these PT balls,
into this teacup, then perhaps we can more easily create...
First, not the one which has been ethanol in before, but a clean one. So the first question...
To preempt the next question... This is getting silly, isn't it? Yeah, probably, but, you know...
Well, it came from somewhere over there.
Hold it up, you silly person!
Info always makes excuses.
Oh, I keep hearing myself saying, oh, that's a good idea, this is gonna be fun. So, where's the, do we have some more, and a cover? Where's the cap? Oh, there. Well, that's enough. How much more do you want to put in there? Yeah, I'm looking for the balloons.
So I put it in the microwave?
Yeah.
Oh, there's still the remainings from our last experiment.
The good glass of your wife. You should hold it so she doesn't see it.
That was about a good oil for my wife. That's not going to work because the pressure is too high. There should be under pressure.
Oh yeah, that's not plugged in.
Da. Wo haben wir da?
Where did I? Oh, there it is.
Also grundsätzlich gefällt mir das Format gut. Ich habe ein bisschen Sorge, dass es so weit geht, bis einer sich wirklich ernsthaft wehtut.
I'm just a bit worried that it's going to continue until somebody is going to get seriously hurt.
Wir sehen, sehen wir nicht. I can see you can't see anything. The pressure. Yeah, the pressure is too high. That's not even going to happen.
Yeah, it was requested, so that's why we did it.
If you cool it down in nitrogen, it doesn't fly up anymore.
Yeah, crazy. Hey. Yeah, nothing's happening. Ping! What? Oh, the disc. And you're gonna take them up on that. Well, all right.
You really want to put one of the last CDs there? Do you want to do it yourself, or is it just too hard?
I mean, it does hurt a bit, but, you know.
We can add a lamp so you can see something.
I'm gonna fetch a new one. One more, one less, doesn't really matter.
I work if it just fits.
Oh. Thank you. At least somebody said not to break the disc.
It was this one. Ooh, it's getting hot.
Are you sure? Well, the scientific reputation's broken.
Do we have
so
something where you can put in there so it's upwards?
Helium! Marshmallow? Marshmallows?
Where is the fluff? Can we put it in there? No, it doesn't fit.
He shoved it into something.
That's too high.
That's too high. Doesn't fit.
Ich glaube, man sieht die Blitze tatsächlich besser ohne
Lampe. I think you'd see the lightning spell without a lamp.
Hier vorne sagt gerade einer, jetzt abspielen. Ich habe ein bisschen Angst, dass er da besser klingt. Somebody told us to, you know, play it now, and I'm kind of afraid that it's gonna sound better now, so let's not do that.
Damn, is that getting hot?
Hey, ich sag's ja nur ungern, aber deine Musik stinkt.
I didn't want to say, but your music stinks.
It's not like I didn't hear that ever before. But wow, that actually stinks. Thanks for playing along with this. Reinhard Remfort and Nicolas Wörl. Methodically wrong. Good night, everyone. And good night, too, from the translation booth. This translation was provided to you by Frau Blauwal, Shanks, Waffle, and Mirian. And we appreciate any feedback that you can give us via Twitter.